We might want to just differentiate between nutritional ketosis and diabetic ketoacidosis.
Absolutely. Diabetic ketoacidosis historically has been a problem more often in patients with type 1 diabetes. It's actually really rare in someone with type 2 diabetes, but can happen. Truly, starting a ketogenic diet, we do not have people go into diabetic ketoacidosis. It is very rare from carbohydrate restriction. But combining carbohydrate restriction and an SGLT2 inhibitor increases the risk, and diabetic ketoacidosis is absolutely different from nutritional ketosis. Absolutely different. In nutritional ketosis, we want those ketones, but they are at an incredibly small degree compared with the state of diabetic ketoacidosis. We're talking well over 10 times different. So that nutritional ketosis state where our ketones are elevated is desired. Diabetic ketoacidosis, totally different. Very, very high ketones that can be dangerous.